Hi guys, thank you for joining me. Yeah, the live webcam for Old Faithful Yellowstone National Park is not working. They changed the location of the webpage, so I don't know if that had anything to do with it. But it's been raining there, and it actually snowed there at Yellowstone. Here's an image from the Washburn Fire Lookout. Now, this was taken almost 6 p.m. this evening. Yeah, you can see the rain clouds over here. Yeah, winter is coming early. Here's another image from the Washburn Fire Lookout. Now, this one is looking southwest. Look at the snow. And here we have an image of Yellowstone Lake. Look at the snow on the trees and on the ground. USGS is reporting 115 earthquakes for the last week. Here we got a magnitude 3.8. That was the most recent of the larger earthquakes. That was today up there along the Snake River Plateau. And I showed you how even the past activity as the hot plume moved up as the North American plate slowly moved going southwest. This is still affected by the plume that's still under there and going up and feeding the caldera of Yellowstone Lake. And as we've seen with the La Palma volcano there at the Canary Islands, any volcano can erupt with little or no notice. They had a series of magnitude 3s, the largest being a 4.2 before it erupted. Yesterday also there was a 3.4. That was at Stanley, Idaho, a 3.0, a 3.4 also yesterday, a 3.5, a 3.7, and a 4.0 yesterday. I want to add that that was just 10 kilometers in depth. So that would be about 6.2 miles below sea level. And today's 3.8, they claim was a 3.8. That too was 6.2 miles in depth or 10 kilometers. Looks like they're all bundled up and it currently has stopped raining. They're looking at Beehive over here. So here we have four different monitors and here is that earthquake that came in. I got Earthquake Lake, Teton Pass, Little West Thumb, and Parker Peak. Remember, it doesn't matter where you take the earthquake signature from, long as you got the full length of the shaking. And we'll go to the signature here. This is from Parker Peak. But it actually comes in as a 3.96. And these is what's called volcanic tremors. That's what it looked like at Earthquake Lake. Now remember, Earthquake Lake, that was formed after the large earthquake that they had in 1959 that created a landslide. That landslide killed a lot of people, cutting off the flow of the river and created Earthquake Lake. Yep, winter's coming early. It's really cold there. We'll probably see more snow on the ground in the morning if it continues to rain. This geyser here is what they call Grand. As we all know that USGS doesn't report earthquakes when they're home. 9 to 5, I guess, is their working hours. Mondays, they often have a meeting once every 2 weeks. And they're reporting 7 earthquakes today for the Yellowstone area. That right there is Hedgin Lake. Right there is Earthquake Lake. Over here, we got Yellowstone Lake. And we got several earthquakes along the Madison River. And this fault zone that comes from Hedgin Lake, Earthquake Lake, and travels across. The last earthquake they are reporting is a little north. It's a 0.0 at 1342. But there's been other earthquakes since this earthquake that they have not reported. The most recent would be at 2319 Universal Time. Yep, brought up a lot of heat. There's more heat showing here than the monitors for La Palma does there at the Canary Islands. there's its signature, and it's not being reported. It comes in as a 2.76. You can see it down there at the bottom, I hope. The next earthquake that's not being reported occurred at about 2244, 2245. It is marked in red here for the monitor for Parker Peak. It's got a long P wave on it. USGS is not reporting the earthquakes that are happening there over in the Canary Islands. Just one example. I don't see this on the monitor for global. Who knows where it happened, but it did not happen there. But this would be a 3.35. Again, this is Parker Peak. Here's the monitor for a Little West Thumb, and it's too hard to tell. Yeah. Where the signature starts and where it ends. But I got a 3.22 here. Yeah, it's really hard to tell. But there at Little West Thumb, yeah, it's been screaming. We got the popping, the cracking of the rock. Remember I talked about how brittle the ground is getting there? And just like glass, it pops and breaks and shatters. And let's look at the signature. Yeah, look at the heat that came up there. We got another one right there. And there was a spot through here where it actually got so loud it went quiet. And of course, now I can't find it. All right, we got some more. Oh, right there. Okay, let me go there. For some reason, we don't have the data. All right, wonder why it didn't pull in the data. All right, 1607, look at the heat. Yeah, right there, that's where it went quiet. Notice that? Let me pull it over a little bit. And we'll go to the earthquake signature. See, absolutely nothing. That's because it got so loud beyond the capability of the machine to pick up the activity. And for those of you that might be new, let me show you where Little West Thumb's at. This here is Yellowstone Lake. This is Little West Thumb. This blew out, 162 to 150,000 years ago, making the lake larger. And those of you that follow me know about this fault line that goes up through here to Yellowstone Lake. You know about the magma that's traveling under the lake and how there is a fault zone through here where dike intrusion is trying to come up through the crust of the earth. Dike intrusion is a crack, just like what's going on at La Palma. And one day it will happen, but what will happen will be far worse than La Palma, because this has a cap of rhyolite. And rhyolite is a type of lava, magma, it's called when it's still under the ground, that is so full of gases it makes it so extremely explosive. So not just with that, we got it under the lake. So when it breaks through and meets up with the water, guess what's going to happen? Yeah, they'll probably have a small tsunami here at the lake. They've had them in the past. An example, when Mary Lake, or Mary Bay, excuse me, Mary Bay formed, when that blew, now that was about 13,800 years ago. Yeah, it created a tsunami, blowing out rocks and debris, and yeah, it went quite a ways across the park. These yellow triangles that I have drawn out is hydrothermal fields. This is where they have venting under the lake of gases that's coming up. One of the larger ones is up over here. And the water down there, because of these hydrothermal vents, is about 340 to 350 degrees. And this canyon, which is down through here following this fault zone, is 390 feet deep. Many years ago, a long time ago, they used to have steamships that went across the lake. And there was a wreckage of the EC Waters that was sunk. And because the lake is tipping from the uplift, It is slowly being exposed now, where it was completely submerged before under the water. Yeah, the satellite view isn't very good, is it? Yeah, the lake's tipping, which exposes barren areas along the shoreline and floods out other shorelines. So again, little West Thumb, this here is what they call blobs of magma that comes into the system. There you go. Yeah, the actual scientific terms is blobs of magma as it travels under the lake. Yep. All right, so we got four monitors, another earthquake at 2036. But this one is the only one, for some strange reason, that picked up the earthquake. I'll make it bigger. Right there. This is harmonic tremors. Harmonic tremors and volcanic tremors, you see, just before an eruption, as the volcano charges for an eruption. Let's look at the spectrogram. Okay, so we got a semi-long P wave on it. And that comes in as a 4.16. It's got a long P wave. Again, I have no idea where it occurred at. So it doesn't show the waveform, but it's right there. Let me close it out. It does show on the monitors. Let me close this one. That's it right there. And let's see. That would be it right there for Parker Peak. Let me pull this back up for you. Yeah, it came in pretty significant at Parker Peak, but the data is missing. All right, we got another one marked in red right there at 1552. Right there. Let's go to the spectrogram. Doesn't really show up at Little West Thumb. It does show at Parker Peak. All right, so there's the signature at Earthquake Lake. It might have been along the Sawtooth Mountain Range. I don't know. We have two monitors. It definitely shows up. That would be the Snake River Plateau. Let's look at its signature. See, it's got a shorter P wave. The P wave is the first signature of an earthquake as it comes in. It goes directly through the Earth, where the second wave is the S wave, and that travels around the outside edge of the Earth. Not being reported, it is a magnitude 2.26. And we'll look at its signature. There you go. All right, another earthquake at 1047. It shows up at the Teton Pass monitor the best. That's actually Teepee Creek. Yeah, volcanic tremors. And that comes in as a magnitude 2.25. Let me bring it down a little bit farther so you can see it. 2.25. 1047. Not being reported. Yeah, brought up a little bit of heat. Yeah, this one right here is another one where the data doesn't show. It too's got a really long P wave on it. Yeah, it first comes in, probably 1948. And then the S wave comes in at 1949. Yeah, I don't know what happened. They'll just tell you that the monitor stopped working. Anyways, here on the stream view, you can see the most recent earthquake that USGS isn't reporting. We also have another small one right there. Not being reported. It does show up on three monitors. This one's on all four. Yeah, the camera keeps stopping and going, stopping and going. So that's all I have for you right now. Any thoughts or comments or questions? Please put those comments down below. Yep, winter is coming early. Hope everyone is ready. Go out and get your snow stuff while you can, if they have it in the stores, or dig them out of storage. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.